Figure skating is growing to be one of the trendiest extracurricular activities in Hong Kong. Harry Lee started to skate at the age of 2 and is a current member of the Hong Kong national team. Today, he comes to the ice rink in Festival Walk Shopping Centre for the Hong Kong Figure Skating Championship 2017. His sister, Phyllis Lee, who was also a former Hong Kong team member, is now sitting on the judging panel as the technical specialist. Having been skating on this ice rink for more than 20 years, the venue of the championship today is more than familiar to Harry and Phyllis Lee.
我係由中二嗰陣決定咗專業訓練嘅，最後DSC考完之後，決定咗唔上大學住啦，咁就去咗哈爾濱嗰邊跟咗國家隊 training。 我喺哈爾濱就 land 咗個 triple axel 嘅 3周半啦，那個動作其實我喺兩三年前已經有做到，不過點解而家做唔翻呢？就係真係場地問題同埋訓練時間嘅問題。喺香港加速去做依一個動作，已經係會俾人話你唔可以流咁快啊！甚至係你跌，你會嚇到其他嘅街客。人哋嘅溜冰場係起喺體育館。 香港嘅溜冰場係起喺商場，同埋正規嘅冰場，即係標準溜冰場嘅 size 係 60×30，但係香港其實最大嘅 mega box 都淨係得 50×20，差好遠啊！嗰10米，香港講溜冰嘅，你諗到嘅係會一齊圍威威去玩啊，又或者係考完 midterm， 考完 final 去邊度玩，哦，溜下冰咯。但係如果外國嘅話，你一講溜冰，我係一種運動嚟。
Harry's sister Phyllis retired from figure skating 5 years ago. Now, as one of the 2 technical specialists in China, she understands her brother's situation better than anyone.
喺香港嚟講咧，場地真係一個問題嚟嘅，唔止係花式溜冰，好多唔同嘅運動或者其他界別咧都係需要土地啦。咁 雖然場地係一個問題，咁但係我哋都盡量會揾一啲可能 off ice 或者另外一啲嘅 training 可以係協助到花式溜冰。雖然資源唔夠之下，但係我都盡量做到最好咯。但係喺細路身上面咧，我睇到佢係好有呢個運動細胞嘅天分，但係場地有限制啦。咁再加上就係其實屋企亦都唔係一個好富裕嘅家庭，咁唔係 afford 到我哋去外國。 甚至喺香港咧，都有教練係話我哋上得唔夠多堂，會因為咁樣然後可能係睇唔起我哋。咁喺呢啲種種嘅情況，我就覺得會唔會即係嘥咗細佬咧？因為佢如果我哋可以俾到更加多資源嘅話咧，佢一定唔知而家咁樣。Why
is a standard ice rink so important to local skaters? How far have Hong Kong skaters achieved in the past 30 years? Edith Lau, an executive officer from Hong Kong Skating Union, provided an answer to the questions.
其實香港一路以嚟啦，30幾年啦，我哋個總會有成，咁都係遇到同一個問題嘅，就係冇個標準場。到而家我哋今年啦，今年其實嚟講，我哋升咗精英 A 嘅項目嘅，咁亦都係冇一個專業場地。我諗喺亞洲地區嚟講啦，都係唯一一個國家冇標準場，但入咗4屆冬奧會。 舊年全國冬季運動會嘅時候咧，梁毅咧就攞咗香港第一面嘅獎牌啦，喺個花式溜冰嗰度。咁再之前我哋亦都有另外一個運動員，佢啱啱退咗役啦，咁就係 Ronald， 咁佢都喺世界錦標賽攞咗啲好好嘅成績。場地標準點解咁緊要呢？因為運動員咧，你知我哋做起跳啦，有嗰個足夠嘅地方去俾佢做滑，咁先可以起到跳。同埋喺外國佢有好多嘅即係專業嘅教練。 我哋香港嚟講，我哋引進嘅教練其實得一個兩個咧，咁始終都唔可以 fulfill 到咁多人嘅要求。The
quest for a standard ice rink has been made for more than 20 years. What is the struggle of the government to include it into the year plan? Dr. Lobo Louis from Hong Kong Association of Sports Medicine and Sports Science shared his opinions.
政府佢一個字就係叫做公帑，每一個 政策嘅範疇都需要公帑㗎。溜冰場喺政府嘅困局嚟講咧，就係地方嘅空間係大啊嘛。 佢唔係話乒乓波台咁，你可能個空間會細啲啦。咁啊，錢仲何來呢？嗱，兩個主要途徑啦，你體育發展嚟講，一係就公堂，一係就靠民間嘅集資啦。民間嘅集資就係睇下你嗰個項目有冇一個商業市場嘅價值。溜冰咁軟件係有一個市場價值嘅。而家好多特別係中產嘅小朋友咧，週末啊、放學啊都去溜冰場俾佢哋玩嘅。咁所以發展嘅話，佢哋需要喺商業市場裏邊嘅策略去做一啲嘢，然後將啲錢落翻嚟佢哋自己呢一個 pool 裏邊，點去再資助翻啲運動員去發展咯。
其實我代表香港出賽嘅時候，我真係覺得我代表緊自己嘅啫。香港係咪有俾到資源呢？嗯。我出亞錦賽都是沒有資源，就算去到全運會了、有天外援空降下來，他們去爭這個香港的名額出賽、我那時候 很不理解，為什麼我已經是去到香港第一了，我那時候已經是連續六屆香港的錦賽冠軍，為什麼都不是派我呢？我知道他們很需要一隻花去俾政府睇，哦，其實而家花滑你呢個協會搞得好好喎，跟住就會俾水你。而家現象就係喺出邊租啲花出嚟，或者買花過嚟咯。咁我唔希望係咁樣咯，我希望係自己，點解唔自己種咧？
嗱，你講緊精英體育，咁但係我比較關心嘅咧就係普及體育。因為而家青少年嗰個體質咧就唔係好差嘅，係非常差嘅，就大約係四個裏邊有一個咧就肥胖。女學生嚟講咧有兩成係過瘦。咁你呢個數字睇都有一半嘅學生啦，基本上係個體質係唔夠強壯。咁唔夠強壯嘅體質咧係影響個社會未來嘅發展嘅，包括咗就係佢嘅毅力啊、佢嘅鬥志啦、佢嘅體格能唔能夠去應付嘅工作啦。咁所以而家嚟講急需要嘅咧，我覺得唔係一個精英嘅體育發展，即係當然啦，有錢繼續去做啦。而更加需要咧，就係一個普及性。
如果話生不逢時咧，又未變太悲觀啊！真係，儘管我哋真係同運動員呢個生涯緣分已了啦，但係其實可以仲有第二啲嘢去 involve 咯。我而家喺冰球學校，主要就係幫佢哋去管理佢哋嘅冰球課程啦，同埋推廣冰球去到社區同埋中小學咯。我係希望可以作為一個好嘅榜樣，以生命影響生命。希望我自己經歷過嘅一啲事情同埋堅持嗰種精神係可以影響到佢哋，令到佢哋咧都係可以喺自己生命裡面揾到中意嘅嘢，然之後堅持落去。
On April the 1st this year, skating became the first ice sports to be included in the Hong Kong Sports Institute's elite program. Securing an elite status will certainly bring more support and public awareness to local skaters, enabling them to aim higher at the 2022 Winter Games in Beijing. But what's next? Will Hong Kong athletes be able to seize their own future after them?